with a new song. Think about it. A song we ain't never heard before. So when we sing these new songs, you know what we're doing? We're actually obeying the commandments of God and obeying the scriptures. Amen? Amen. So y'all get ready to worship with us this morning.
Thank you.
songs, and we can come stand and put those hands together and help Brother Tim keep that beat going. Amen. Let's worship the Lord.
Thank you.
love to come.
I can't hear you anymore.
But you know, the devil didn't want us to come to church this morning and praise him.
That's right.
I appreciate Sister Shirley pushing it through, got the good truth, and doing her best to sing, even though her voice is bothering her this morning. During practice, I broke the guitar string. Amen. And I'm so proud of my wife for not being ashamed to worship him.
Yes.
If you came by the church and saw her yesterday, you wouldn't think that she would have the strength to be up here this morning. You see, the devil's been attacking on every side. On every side. So maybe the devil's been attacking you. I got phone calls from folks that say, pray for me, I'm sick. Maybe the devil's been attacking you. I don't know where you are. As Brother Timothy's ready to sing this last song for us, I just want to encourage you, worship. Like the first song said, the praises of God lead to the heart of God.
Amen.
So can you worship with this last song?
Oh.
by faith in Jesus we give. Because he said our faith is what we need to stand on. And I'm sorry, I just, Lord, I just thank you that you know, God, and you felt this, and you've been healed. He's got so much mercy for us. But I don't deserve to be healed every day. Instead, it's like every day I'm going to be healed. Because there's an attack from here and an attack from there. I don't even see them half the time. It's like I'm getting blindsided and tackled from afar, you know. But when it happens, I have to turn to him. And I turn to him so much now, he is my life. He is my life. From the time I wake up, even while I'm sleeping, he's in there. But he is my life. And that is where I tell and say, no more. No more. He cannot touch us anymore. He's not hurting my body. He's not hurting me anymore. He's not hurting any of y'all anymore. By the blood of Jesus.
Church meeting after service today as well. So the women's going to have to quit after church meeting. Amen. Praise the Lord. Sorry, we ain't got nowhere else to be but in the house of the Lord today. Amen?
Amen.
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 Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I choose to rejoice in it.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Romans chapter 12 and verse 2. And do not be conformed, or in other words, transformed, to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of the mind. Father, I ask you for your anointing upon your word.
Amen.
Your word is always anointed. Father, I ask you for anointing upon our ears to receive and to comprehend. God, hide your servant behind the cross. Like Dr. Shambach used to say, God, hide me behind the cross, God.
Amen.
And let your presence be seen in this church. And everybody said,
Amen.
And amen. Hallelujah. I appreciate you standing for reading of God's word this morning. Romans chapter 12 and verse 2. Do not be conformed. Catch this for me. Do not be conformed or transformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of the mind. In other words, church, you've got to get the word of God in your mind so it can get in your spirit. Amen? When it gets into your mind and you begin to think about the Word of God, it'll drop down into your soul. It'll drop down into your spirit. And the Holy Ghost inside of you will bear witness with the Word of God. Come on, somebody. I'm talking about being a renewed mind this morning. Set free by the power of the Holy Ghost this morning. Set free by the power of God's Word this morning. Woo, hallelujah. Don't allow the influencers in the world to conform you. Don't let the influencers transform you to be like the world in their sinful nature.
Amen.
In their sinful nature. Ooh, come on. I'm going to preach something this morning some of y'all ain't going to like, but I'm going to tell you the truth whether you like it or not. Amen?
Amen. Come on, brother.
Amen.
Don't allow. Listen to what I'm saying. You need to take some notes, look around, you'll find some paper around your seat. Some of you need to take notes and bring your Bible to church. Don't allow the influences in this world to conform you or transform you to be like the world in their sinful nature. No, become a separated people.
Amen.
Separate from the world and be apart for the glory of God. Separate yourself from the world and be set apart for the glory of God. Of God.
Amen.
What does that mean, Pastor? That means that you can't hang out with just anybody.
Right.
Come on.
Right.
That means that the Pentecostal church used to have a saying. I think maybe we need to roll pop back a little bit and go back to some of the old Pentecostal sayings. Amen. I don't dip, I don't chew, I don't smoke, and I don't hang out with those that do.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Well, y'all didn't catch yet. See, some of y'all don't have to. Some of y'all folks, y'all don't have to teach the younger generations.
Yeah.
I don't dip, I don't chew, I don't smoke, I don't drink, and I don't hang out with those that do. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
A separated people.
Yeah.
I told you I was an old school preacher.
Y'all,
I'm one of them old preachers, amen.
Yeah.
Give me some of that old school Pentecostal preaching.
Amen.
Woo, hallelujah. Mm. Hallelujah. But today we're to be transformed.
Yes.
Not to the world, but into the image of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Into the image of Jesus Christ. 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 13 and 15. You need to go there because you need to see what Paul wrote in his word. In 2 Corinthians chapter 11 and verse 13 through 15, by the way, this is part 7 of B. Renewed, be recreated, and be transformed. Say, preacher, when are you going to get done? I don't know. God just keeps pouring it on me.
Amen.
Amen. There might be a part 20. There might be a part 25. I told my little granddaughter the other day, I said, I need you to proofread some things. See, most of the time when I'm writing out a sermon, I get to about 5 pages. I know that's 30 minutes. And the Lord usually cuts me off right there, and then I'm going to preach that sermon. But when I got to page 15, I said, God, what are you doing? What are you doing? I said, God, this is turning into a book. He said, what's wrong with that?
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I might be writing a book here. I don't know. Because right now I got 38 pages. page 5 to 38 pages. And I'm only on page 33 this morning. Amen. Amen. Y'all got anywhere to go today? Amen. Y'all got anything else better to do? No. Ain't got nothing else better to do. Alabama's already played. Georgia's already played. Come on, somebody. And I don't care to watch one bit of the news anymore. Amen. Amen. Don't got no news to watch today. Praise God. Amen. Ain't got no business to do. 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 13. It says, for such are false prophets, deceitful workers, transforming, look at that word, transforming themselves, mm-hmm. or in other words, conforming themselves, transforming themselves into the apostles of Christ. Is that what your Bible says?
Mm-hmm. What mine says. Exactly.
Into the apostles of Christ. And no wonder, for Satan himself, listen to this, transforms himself into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing for his ministers, look at that, his ministers also transform themselves into ministers of righteousness, whose end will be according to their works. I'm convinced, based on this scripture, that the Antichrist is going to be a preacher. Amen. There's going to be a lot of things, but I think preaching is going to be one of them. He might be a pastor of a church right now that's already alive. And some people think it's me, but it ain't. I'm going to tell you right now.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. But look at what it says. That his ministers also transform themselves into ministers of righteousness, whose end will be according to their works. I mean, we know the word angel means messenger, also means the word minister. Okay? They're sent forth as ministering spirits. So you can say this is angels, but what if it's more than just an angel? What if it's actually a human man preaching the gospel? Hello? Hello? Transforming himself into ministers of righteousness, whose end will be according to their works. Listen to this. The devil and his crew can transform themselves into angels of light, preachers of righteousness, and they can talk the talk, come on, and they can even fool you into thinking they're walking the walk. Hello. Right. You know, you might be able to talk the talk, but you can't fool everybody if you're walking the walk. Right. Listen, the devil himself, he quotes scriptures and talk the talk. Right. But the problem with the devil is he can't walk the walk. Woo, glory to God.
Right.
I said he can't walk the walk. You got to be in true holiness, true righteousness, and be truly transformed into the righteousness of the image of Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. To walk the walk. Amen. But they will pull you down with their evil world, and they will transform you into their image and into their likeness. Listen to what I'm saying. Don't be conformed into the world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of the mind. Your mind is your soul. I ain't talking about your brain. Your brain will decay in the grave, but you will continue to think thoughts. Because your mind is your soul. Come on. By the transforming of the renewing, in other words, make new. Renew, make new of the mind. Transform of the mind. To be a transformed person, a transformed soul. You see, this is why you need to know what your Bible says for yourself.
Amen.
This is why you need to bring your Bible to church. This is why I'm telling you, church, I believe I got this from the Holy Ghost, that you need to get an old-fashioned Bible that you can hold in your hand, that does not have to be charged up, that does not have to be on Wi-Fi. Hello, somebody. I'm talking about an old-fashioned, black and white, on the paper, out of the red words of Jesus on paper, and the black words, come on, of everything of prophets. Come on, somebody. You need to have the Word of God that you can hold in your hand, because the Antichrist, the devil, will take every scripture out there that's on the electronic Bible and change it. And you know what? He's already doing it. That's why you got to be careful what translation you read. And that's why I tell you, go on and read another translation. We're going to read a little bit of the Amplified today. But this is my foundation. King James has got to be my foundation.
Yeah.
It's got to be my foundation. Amen. I might need another translation to help me understand a word here and there. But King James has got to be my foundation. I'm telling you, because if you get away from King James, you could fall into error. Could fall into error. There's a, now, I'll go into that another time. I've already taught some of you how they took the whole scriptures out of other translations. But we're to be renewed. We are to be recreated. Yes. And we are to be transformed. Transformed. And this should take place in our life right now. I'm not talking about you getting a renewed mind when you get to heaven. I'm not, of course, you're going to have one. I'm not talking about a recreated soul. Come on, when you get to heaven and a transformation. Listen, you ain't going to be transformed into heaven if you don't get a renewed mind on earth. Enoch, I go back to Enoch.
Amen.
It would be impossible for Enoch to have been transformed or translated, walk into heaven before he died. He man did not die. He was transformed, translated, carried away into heaven had he not first went through a transformation of his thinking, a recreation of his soul and his spirit, a recreation on the inside had to take place before he could be translated or transformed into the heaven's paradise today. You want to go on a rapture? Honey, you better get your mind right with God.
Amen.
Amen. So everybody, I don't care if I go on the rapture or go by the grave. You still better get your mind right with God. Because on that day, there are going to be many that say, Lord, Lord, and call on his name. And he's going to say, depart from me, ye worker of iniquity, for I knew you not. You might say, I know Jesus, but does Jesus know you? Yeah. That's the important question this morning. Does Jesus know you? The Lord brought the caterpillar to my mind. And I never studied bugs. I'm not a bug expert. I don't understand crawly, creepy things. I could care less about that kind of stuff. But the Lord brought a caterpillar to my mind. Now, a caterpillar is an ugly creature. Come on, and it is. Some of them got on little legs. I mean, it just ain't look, only look after. Got on little legs underneath that thing. And it crawls around on its belly, on its little bee legs. And it crawls around in the dirt of the earth. Am I telling the truth this morning? Come on. It has to climb up into the trees, but it's got to get to that tree somehow, and it sure can't jump. So it's got to crawl through the dirt to get there, to the tree. But something happens to the caterpillar. It goes into what we know as a transformation. How many of y'all with me this morning? It goes into a transformation. It goes into like a little canoe, not a canoe, but a womb, I'm trying to say. Like a woman's womb. It goes into like a womb, and it begins to change. It begins to transform. And when it comes out of that place, come on somebody, it is a beautiful butterfly. A butterfly that no longer has to crawl through the dirt and the filth of the world. A God wants to do the same thing with the church. He wants to take you that's crawling through that old filthy sin and through that old dirt of sin, and he wants to transform you into a beautiful creature, a new creation in Christ Jesus. Where all things are passed away, and behold, all things are new. Glory to God. I feel the preacher in the house this morning. Amen. I told somebody, as much as the devil's fighting on Saturday, I'm looking for a Holy Ghost pouring on Sunday. Amen. Amen. Praise God. I was talking to another preacher. I told him the words of Shimlock. I said, yeah, watch that anointing. You get under that anointing, you feel like Superman. When that anointing lifts on, you go back to normal. You know, you don't feel like Superman no more. You're like I call it a wore-out dish rag. Just bring that. But right now, I feel like Superman in my spirit. Hallelujah. I feel the preacher in the house of God. The Holy Ghost is here, church. Ready to transform your thinking and recreate your soul. Come on, and give you a transformation physically with healing. And mentally, we need a transformation mentally this morning.
Amen.
Emotional healing this morning. Ooh, hallelujah. That's good preaching about that caterpillar. Stay with me. Go back to Romans chapter 12 and verse 2. This time I'm going to read it to you from the Amplified Bible. You look at it in the King James and know it's what you got. I'm going to read to you the Amplified Bible. Look at it this way. And do not be conformed, Romans chapter 12, verse 2, to this world, any longer in its superficial values or customs. Look at that. Do not be conformed to this world any longer with its superficial values and customs, but be transformed by the progressive change as you mature spiritually. By the renewing of your mind, focusing on God's values and ethical attitudes, so that you may prove yourself what the will of God is, and that which is good and acceptable and perfect in His plan and purpose for you.
Amen.
I'm going to read the same scripture to you in NLT, New Living Translation. I don't always like everything NLT has, but I did like this one. Don't copy the behavior and the customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Come on. We need to change the way we think. But don't copy the behavior and the customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think when you learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. Now go with me to 2 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 14. Before we get there, as we turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 14, I want to take your mind back to the scripture we just read that said that Satan himself can transform himself into an angel of light. Many years ago, I was shocked when I realized that the devil could also transform himself into a middle-aged woman, or a middle-aged man, or an 8-year-old child. Listen to what I'm saying. If he can transform himself into an angel of light, he can transform himself into your best friend. Mm-hmm. Amen? You got to listen to when people are talking to you. I listen to people when they talk. Not every thought that comes in their head is their own thought. And not every thought that comes in their head is from God. Sometimes the devil will put a thought in their head and they will speak to you out of that thought that is satanic and demonic. Amen? To you. Like I said, I was shocked the first time I ran across a middle-aged person, and I knew it was the devil's words coming out their mouth. Amen. Some of you need to think about who you're hanging out with and who your friends are and who you're listening to. Who you're listening to. Everybody cannot be in your circle of trust. Are you listening? You need to have a circle of trust, and everybody can be in that circle of trust, because not everybody is for your good. Some people are out to just destroy you, and some people would rather see you fall than succeed.
Amen.
And let me go ahead and tell you, you can't share your dreams with everybody either. God can give you a dream, give you a vision, and you tell somebody that dream and vision, and what they do, they cut it down. You can't do that, this is why. You can't do that, this is why. Amen. That's just a little side note, y'all. Somebody needed that. 2 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 14. Do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers. Well, it got real quiet in this Presbyterian church right there.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. It got real quiet. Do not. That's a commandment, church. Do not. Do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers, for what fellowship have righteousness with lawlessness, and what communion has light with darkness, and what accord has Christ with Baal, or what part of the believer with an unbeliever, and what agreement has the temple of God with idols? For you are the temple of the living God. And God said, I will dwell in them and walk among them and be their God, and they shall be my people. Amen. You are the temple of God.
Amen.
You are the church. The building we are in is just a building. It's sticks, it's mortar, it's bricks, it's concrete, but it's not the church. We, the people, are the church, the temple, the real temple of Jesus Christ this morning.
Amen.
Verse 17. Therefore, come out from among them and be separate, says the Lord. Do not touch what is unclean, and I will be a father to you, and you shall be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty. 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1. Look at verse 1. Therefore, having these promises, beloved, let us cleanse ourselves. Notice the scripture don't say, let the pastor clean you. Come on. Notice the scripture don't even say, let Jesus clean you. It says, clean yourself. When you learn how to walk, you have to put one foot in front of the other. If you don't put one foot in front of the other, nobody else is going to do it for you. You've got to learn to renew your mind, get in God's Word, stay in prayer, and cleanse your own selves.
Amen.
With the Word of God. Cleanse yourself from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. So let's write down these three things. Number one, do not be conformed to this world. Number two, do not copy the behavior and customs of this world.
Amen.
Number three, do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers. Now that does not say you turn into a snob when you walk out the door of the church. Come on. We don't turn into a snob. And let me get my holy glasses. I saw this old somewhere getting a bottle of chicken and beans. Come on. Brother so-and-so got a drinking problem. I smelled out Hoffman's reference. Come on. Listen, I ain't going to hang out with you while you're drinking, but I ain't going to look down on you either. Amen? I'm not going to stop talking to you because you're in sin, but guess what? I'm not going to get in the sin with you and party it up with you in the sin. But I'm going to love you and pray for you, and I'm going to continue to say hello. I'm going to continue to say thank you. I'm going to continue to be the hands and the feet of Jesus Christ for you.
Amen.
So let's be separate. Let's stand up. Amen. So number three, do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers. Listen, church, that's more than just getting married. Don't marry an unbeliever. Marry a Christian. Hello?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I am so sick of these young women.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, but I could give them a chance. Oh, but if I marry him, I think he'll change. He'll start going to church with me. Honey, the truth is, if he won't go to church before you get married, he ain't going to go to church after you get married. Come on, somebody. If he won't stop drinking before you get married, he won't stop drinking after you get married. Come on, somebody. Mom, listen, before I married that woman, she said you're going to have to stop smoking marijuana. What a shocking look on your face, Pastor. You used to smoke marijuana? Yeah, I used to drink. I used to run around. I used to smoke cigarettes. I used to cuss. I used to fight. Oh, I thought preachers came out of their mama holy.